VA 2022-12.
All right, thank you, Madam Chairman. This is also regarding a request by Hamilton Dickey for property consisting of 1.44 acres, zoned R10. The request is to rezone it to highway commercial CH. Property is located at 1705 Ellis Drive. This is along the east side of the road, about halfway between North St. Augustine Road and Baytree Road. You can see from the zoning map on the screen, it's a mixed zoning area, but this property is sort of wedged in between the commercial corridors of Morton and St. Augustine, and less intensive zonings and development to the north and west. Character area, this is Community Activity Center. So just like an earlier case, the R10 zoning that is there is non-compliant because it is not intensive enough. Property is a little bit interesting, recent changes in the land use. R10 property here used to have a single-family residence on it. It's been recently demolished. The property to the north that you see on the screen is also R10. Still has a single-family residence on it, but I believe it is rental property in need of a little bit of TLC. You've noticed the RM zoning across the street to the west. That is the backside of the condominium project that faces Spring Hill. It was built about 15 years ago. The applicant is proposing to combine this R10 property with the CH property to the east. That property to the east was the Astro Exterminating Facility, which has also been closed and also recently demolished. And so they're wanting to combine the properties together and market them together for commercial development. Perhaps as one development, but still with the two frontages on roads, front and rear, has the potential to be redeveloped separately. So you see the character area, the aerial imagery shows the pattern. Some of our largest or tallest hotels are nearby. The Hilton Garden Inn is to the southeast. A new motel, I think four-story, is developed to the southwest. Survey is in the packet. Such a property is seen from Ellis Drive, recently cleared away with the demolished building. The driveway to the south, which goes through a gated area, already being marketed as commercial property, almost 3 acres worth. That would be all of those properties together. Looking southward down Ellis Drive, you see where the commercial begins with the motel on the right. The backside of the Hilton Garden Inn, which is sort of the back entrance to the parking lot, which is straight across the street from it. This is looking toward the tree lines along Ellis Drive with the condominium multifamily beyond the trees. And it's also down a pretty steep grade. In fact, I think it's a retaining wall that is there. No access directly from that to Ellis Drive, which I think is an important note. And then the rental house to the north, also for sale. And I think it has seen better times. Immediately north of that is a point of reference. It's the Black Crow Media office building. This is when you get into the OP zoning. Properties to the east facing Gorto Road. This is looking westward from Gorto, across where Astro Exterminating used to be. As we talked about at the work session and as mentioned in your packet, staff is a bit concerned about the speculative nature of this request for CH zoning without a proposed use, without a proposed site plan. CH, as you know, allows for some fairly intensive commercial uses. The surrounding area, even though there's a lot of CH zoning, those are all CC type uses in general retail. That might be acceptable there, but there's still a concern of Ellis Drive, the speculative nature. And because of that, staff is recommending the lighter commercial district of CM. I did a comparison of all three zoning districts, so you can see the differences, and that's the last two pages of your packet. And again, CN allows a lot of the lighter commercial uses, which I think would be acceptable in Ellis Drive. CC might be, depending on which use. But CH, you get into the trucking terminals, heavy automotive body shops, things that might not be a good idea. So with that, the recommendation is for CN zoning instead of these requested CH. I'd like to answer any questions you may have.
Have you discussed the CN with the applicant?
Have not. I was not present at the pre-app meeting. I think staff gave some concern. concerns about Ellis Drive and CH. That's what my staff had told me. But I believe the applicant's here.
Matt, the former Astro property, I'll refer to it as that, that has been acquired by the applicant already, or did you say that?
It's all under the same ownership. The applicant is the realtor representing.
Okay.
The owners. They're the ones that have the name on the real estate sign. But if the same, all those vacant properties are under the same ownership, which I believe is the Colbert Family Partnership.
Yes. And I'm referring to the zoning location map, this next question. The R10 block just north of this request, is that same ownership, different, or?
Different ownership. That's the rental house.
Okay.
It has a for sale sign in the yard.
Yes, with a different realtor.
Right. All right, any other questions? All right, we'll open it to the public. Is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request? If you'll please come forward, just state your name and address for the record, please.
Hamilton Bickey, 5 Moss Trail Circle, Dallas, Georgia. We've had several buyers that are interested in this property. Obviously, they were concerned about R10, they want to make it a little more seamless. And I know that I represent the family that owns this, and they just kind of, they want to sell it all as one piece, whether it be a hotel or one restaurant, they don't want anybody to develop it, they just want one owner. And the subject property has been marked as commercial for sale as well. And Astro used to use this, that house that was back there, that's why when I first got it, I thought that was already zoned commercial, that's where all Astro trucks are, and they came in out right there. But since then, they have moved down everything. We're just trying to make it a little more seamless for when the sale does go through.
What are your thoughts about CN versus CH?
I think it'd be fine.
You know, CN will not allow for lodging, so.
Well, most of the places that are interested in that, they want the frontage, like, say, a big restaurant. They want a warrant, they want to use back more of the parking lot, they would have access.
So you would be fine then with CN?
I'd be fine with it, but, I mean, I'd rather it be CH. That's what I'll take right here.
Well, I wish they were all as easy as you are. Commissioner Willis? No? Okay. All right, thank you, Mr. Dickens. All right, is there anyone else here tonight who would like to speak on behalf? All right, if not, is there anyone tonight wishing to speak against this request? Anyone wishing to speak against? Okay, let's turn it back over to the commissioners. Any discussion?
Madam Chair, just for the record, I suppose, I'm more inclined to allow CH in this case than CN. I do see the differences with respect to staff that they have noted and included in the package that you've given us a chart. But I do not, quite frankly, see the imminent danger of CH right here.
Okay.
That's my opinion.
All righty.
Yeah, I'm kind of inclined to agree with it, because it's touching CH everywhere.
Right.
So.
And there's one residential property, I believe, left on that street. All right, if there's no other discussion, I'll call for a motion.
Madam Chairman?
Yes.
Reference to the 2022-12, rezoning R10 to highway commercial. I make a motion, we recommend approval. That's it, we'll leave it like that.
Approval to?
Just rezoning.
To?
To CH.
To CH.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Okay. All right, we have a motion to rezone to CH. Do I have a second? All right, Commissioner Vowles? Any discussion? All those in favor of the motion to rezone to CH, raise your right hand. All those against, and that motion carries.